Hello students, this is Mr. Nagesh R. Tambake, Assistant Professor, Department of Mechanical Engineering, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today I am dealing with the topic Performance of Automobile Part 3. Learning outcome: at the end of this session, students will be able to analyze the performance parameters of an automobile. In the previous session, we have discussed all performance parameters. Today we will discuss how to analyze the performance parameters. Now, to analyze the performance parameters, we have to calculate maximum acceleration, maximum tractive effort and reactions for different drives. In this figure, forces acting on a wheel in motion it is shown. Here B is nothing but the wheel base, then CG is nothing but center of gravity, F is nothing but the acceleration, W is nothing but the weight of the vehicle, G is nothing but acceleration due to gravity, FR is nothing but FR and FF is nothing but the tractive effort at rear wheel and front wheel respectively, mu is nothing but the coefficient of adhesion between the tires and the road surface. Now we will see how to analyze the tractive effort and traction in front engine front wheel drive. So here the maximum tractive effort is FF is equal to mu RF is acting on the front wheel. As we are giving drive to the front, therefore tractive effort is acting at the front wheel. It produces maximum forward acceleration and the inertia force opposite to acceleration. If we take the vertical forces is equal to 0, summation of vertical forces is equal to 0, we will get W is equal to RF plus RR. Now, if you take the horizontal summation of horizontal forces is equal to 0, then FF is equal to mu RF, because we are giving the drive to the front wheel. FF is equal to mu RF is equal to W by G into F. Then, as we are dealing with the front wheel, therefore we need to take the moment about the rear wheel. Therefore, we are taking moment about the rear wheel, RF into B plus W by G into F into H. This is the W by G into F into H, that is both are anti-clockwise direction, and this is the clockwise WL force moment. Substituting the values of RF, this is the RF, and we put the RF value over here, you will get this expression. After that, our aim is to calculate the maximum acceleration, therefore we are taking maximum acceleration outside, and we will get F by G, this much ratio. From this we can calculate the maximum acceleration. Now this particular maximum acceleration formula, if we put in this particular equation, then we will get RF, and if you put RF in this particular equation, then you will get RR. This is all about the maximum acceleration, tractive effort and the reactions at the front wheels. Now next one is the rear wheel drive. Rear wheel drive, as we are giving drive to the rear wheel, therefore we need to consider FR is equal to mu RR. Here FF is neglected. If you take vertical forces equal to 0, then we will get W is equal to RR plus RF, and if you take horizontal forces is equal to 0, gives FR is equal to mu RR W by G into A. And if you take, as we are giving the drive to the rear, then definitely we need to take the moment about the front wheel, and that gives RR into B is equal to W into B minus L plus W by G into F into H. Substituting the values of RR in the above equation, we will get this particular equation. Then as we need to calculate the maximum acceleration, we will get the maximum acceleration from this particular formula. F by G is equal to mu into B minus L divided by B minus mu H. And same thing as we have calculated previously, RR and RF value, we can calculate RF and RR value over here. This is all about the rear wheel drive. Next one, the drive is given to all wheels. Here we are giving drive is given to all wheels. Therefore, F is equal to FR plus FF, As we know, FR and FF value, they are mu RR plus mu RF. Therefore, and if we take vertical moment is equal to 0, then W is equal to RF plus RR. And here, horizontal forces equal to 0, if you take W by G into F is equal to mu RR plus mu RF. If you take mu common, then RR plus RF, and RF, RR plus RF is nothing but W. Therefore, that equation becomes mu W. Here, we will get, if we take that value into account, WW will be getting cancelled, and FYG is equal to mu that we are getting. Then vertical forces, if you take 0, then W is equal to RR plus RF that we are getting. Here, we need to consider the third differential. Due to considering the third differential, what will happen? The tractive effort and tractive effort at the front and the tractive effort and at the rear, both are same. Therefore, mu RR and mu RF are equal due to application of third differential, where mu is the critical working coefficient of inertia being less than mu, the limiting value. Therefore, assuming the slip to rear at front wheels first, RF is less than RR, then we are getting this expression 2 mu RF is equal to W by G into F. And then if we take the moment about rear wheel, then we will getting the expression as we have calculated before, substituting the values of RF again over here, and we will get F by G ratio, that is, we can calculate from this formula the maximum acceleration. Now here you can see, with the help of that particular A by G, we can able to calculate the RF and RR value by putting this A by G value in the first equation. Now here, if we take the reverse condition, if RR is less than RF, then 2 mu RR is equal to W by G into F. Here we need to take the moment about the front. Please consider. And the equation that we are getting after taking the moment about front wheel is this. Then from that, we need to calculate the A by G ratio. Again the same, by putting this A by G value into first equation, this equation, we will get RR and RF values. Now next one, it is very important to know the stability of a vehicle on a slope. Here, vehicle is climbing on a slope. Then, therefore, now we will resolve this particular weight into parallel and perpendicular direction to the slope respectively. Therefore, W sin theta is equal to FF plus FR. This is the horizontal forces is equal to 0. Therefore, taking vertical forces is equal to 0, we will get W cos theta is equal to RF plus RR. And if you are taking moment about the front wheel, it gives WH sin theta plus RR into B is equal to W into B minus L cos theta. Therefore, RR is equal to, we are getting this particular formula. And hence, RF we can get from this particular formula. This is the RF. We are having two conditions. If the theta, angle theta is increased gradually, in a situation arises when either the vehicle is about to overturn or the vehicle is about to slide down the slope. Now here, the instability due to case A happens at the point when RR becomes 0, and hence, we need to take RR becomes 0 over here. Therefore, the limiting value of angle theta L for overturning is given by tan theta L is equal to B minus L divided by H. If the theta L value is greater than this limiting value, definitely your vehicle is going to overturn. This indicates that at the point of overturning, the line of action of the weight passes through the contact point of F. Therefore, at this condition, RR becomes 0. For the case to arise, the limiting value of theta is given by W is equal to sin theta is equal to FR plus FF. The value of FF plus FR can be determined under the following condition. Let us the brakes be applied to prevent this situation. Then two cases may arise. One is the brakes are not efficient enough to prevent the wheels from the turning before they slide. In this case, the limiting value of theta can be determined by the brake torque available. If TF and TR are the braking torques at the front wheel and rear wheels respectively, then TF is equal to FR into RR, TR is equal to FR into R, where R is the radius of the wheel. If you take the rearrange the formula, we will get this is equal to W sin theta L, and sin theta, we will get in the form of TF plus TR divided by W into R. Now the second condition is that the brakes are sufficiently powerful for the coefficient of adhesion mu to limit the sliding of the vehicle, then we will get FF plus FR is equal to mu into RF plus RR. As RF plus RR is equal to W, we will get this. Therefore, FF plus FR is equal to W sin theta. If we equate these both value, we will get W sin theta L is equal to mu W cos theta L. Therefore, tan theta L is equal to mu. This limiting value is totally depends upon the coefficient of adhesion between the rod and the wheel. These are the references. Thank you.